Then after this ayat, something else happens. Okay. So let me go to the brief of that, which we did. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ. Someone went again and said to these munafiqeen. Okay. Some person who had believed sincerely, or somebody else. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ. They said to the munafiqeen, آمِنُوا. It's my advice that believe. So this person goes and says, please believe. How? Kama amana nas, the same way other people are believing in the message of the Quran and the Prophet and Deen. There are sincere people who are believing and they are submitting themselves. So believe just like them. Do what they are doing after they are believing, not the way you are acting after believing, claiming that you are believing. So what they say, they reply to these people again. Qalu, they say, the munafiqeen say. Now notice again that in this ayat, there are three speakers in the same ayat. One speaker is somebody who just went and spoke to the munafiqeen. So this is what he said believe. That's one word. Just like other people believed. Okay. So then he stopped here. That's all this first person said to the munafiqeen. Then second speaker now are the munafiqeen or hypocrites themselves. They are saying something. So their statement starts from here. Qalu. They said. They replied. So qalu is applying to the hypocrites, the munafiqeen. What did they reply? Anu'minu. Should we believe? We'll translate this, but the meaning is that their answer is that should we believe? Or are we going to believe? Kama, just like amanas sufaha, the foolish people have believed. Okay? So, this nas were those people who were sincerely believing. Hypocrites are saying that these nas or these people are fools.
They're making joke with them.
They are making joke. They are saying that those people are actually fools, that they are believing in the Quran and the Prophet. So are we going to be fools like them? Okay, so this is their response. This is their reply. Okay, so they make, this is the statement of hypocrites. All they did not say, we are going to believe or not believe. All they are saying, should we believe like the fools? That's all they said. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not like their statement. Okay. So the third statement is from here to the end of the ayat is the statement from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is declaring something now in response to this statement they made. Okay, what is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying? Allah innahum. Is it not that they, these are the same words, we looked into that. Humus sufaha, they themselves are the fools. Is it not that? Or beware or watch that these people are themselves fools and they are calling the sincere people as fool. And this time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَكِنْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Same words except there was yashurun. Here it is yalamun. Yalamuna means to know. Yashuruna means to understand. So Allah is saying that, but they don't know anything. Before Allah says that they don't understand anything, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying they do not know anything. Okay. So this is the third speaker, who is the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this part of the ayat. Okay. So now let's look at the words of the beginning from the ayat. So the ayat starts with wa. Wa means end. The next word is iza. Iza means when. Iza means when. And when. Allah is saying and when. And this word here, qaf, waw, and lam, this means to say. And if we put one fatha on each of them, the middle one will be pronounced as alif. Qala. Qala means he said. If someone, third person, says something, Arabic word for that is qala. Comes a lot in the Quran. Qala Allah Ta'ala. Allah said. Qala means someone said in the past. Third person. Okay? Now, if we make a change like that, instead of qala, we say qila. Okay? Qila means it was said. So, in English, it is active voice and passive voice. This statement, he said, is active. Someone has said something. If something was said to that person, it is passive. And the Arabic for that passive is that you make a couple changes here. It's qila. Qila means it was said. So, wa'idha qila, and when it was said. It was said. Also notice that in this word qila, the speaker is not known. In the word qila, we don't know who said it. Somebody said something. So someone went to the hypocrite, to the munafiq, and he said something. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reporting that incident, that someone said something. So that's the meaning of وَإِذَا قِيلَ, and then لَهُمْ, two words. لَهُمْ, لَا means two, and هُمْ means them. And then here are hypocrites. So someone went and said something to the hypocrites. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is quoting that situation by saying وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ, and when it was said to them. Okay? The exact same words were in the previous ayat last time. And when it was said to them. So now someone is saying something. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is quoting what this person said to the munafiqeen. Okay? So let's look at the next word. Now the word starts with these three letters, alif, mim and noon. Okay. This means to have peace. To have peace, aman. Okay. But if we add another alif in the beginning, it becomes two alifs and a noon. This word, two alifs, can also be written as one hamza and one alif. And the meaning of this word is to believe, amana, iman. This is amana, one word, this one sound of alif, that means peace. But when you have two alifs here, which can be written this way, ah, you are stretching the two alifs together, this means to believe. And all the words that we learn from this, amanu or iman or other words, are from this word here, amana. Now, if I write down this one this way, a fata on the first hamza and combine meem with the noon like min, amin. Okay? Amin means an order that you are giving someone. Do it. Amin means believe. And command in English as well as in Arabic has usually several sections of it. If you are ordering, like you have a child, and you tell him to do something, you're ordering him to do something. Okay? It's a command. But if you are asking an elder person to do something, even though it is coming under the order, but it is not order, it's a request. Okay? So request is a part of the order. Telling someone to do is order, requesting is order. Okay? If you're advising something, you're suggesting to someone, please do it. That's also order, but it's a different way. When you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are making a supplication, you are making a dua. That is also an order, but there the meaning of that order will be making dua. Okay? So anytime you address a person and say, do this for me, person or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are asking that person to do something. So here, the person is saying, believe. Okay? So he's saying, in this case, it will be something like someone advising something, okay? Because two people, okay, one person went to Munafiq and said, believe. Simple advice, some suggestion, okay? So, Amin, if you tell one person to do something, believe in something, you will say, Amin. If I put a vowel after that and within an alif like that, which is not recited, it will become Aminu. It becomes plural. Plural means you are telling many people, believe. Okay? So that's the word in the Quran, Aminu, believe. So, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ, and when it is said to them, to the munafiqin, Aminu, believe. Okay. Have faith. Okay. And then this person is now just saying that have faith or believe. But he is giving an example of other people who have already believed. That this is the standard of belief. That other people have believed and they have submitted and they are striving and they are being honest. So you should believe just like the other peoples. Other people have believed by saying, Kama amanas sufaha. Okay? So let's look at those words. So the word they are ka and ma. First word is made of two. Ka, kaf with a fatha, ka and ma. So this ka means like or same, and ma means that. Okay. So this thing can be translated as same as or same as that. Kama means same as or like as or in a similar way. Kama, same as. Okay. Now also, this word we just learned, amana. Amana by itself means he believed. Like if you have these three letters, fa, an, and lam, means to do. And if you put a fata on each of them, fa ala, that means he, third person, in the past tense. Fa ala means he did. Okay, by adding a fata on each of these three letters, the grammar mean it becomes he, third person, and past tense, he did. So if I apply the same thing here, if I just take that and put a fata on each of those, like that, okay, this, there you have to stretch it, a-mana, a-mana means he believed, just like he did, okay, so kama, a-mana, means he believed. He believed. Same as he believed. Okay? Okay. So, one more thing before I go to the next word. The rule is that when there is a hamza and there is alif before the hamza, then you pronounce this alif with a mad. Okay? So, kama should be pronounced as kama. Okay? Very important to pronounce Quran correctly, that it's already written as a hamza there, I mean, is a mad there. Okay? But why mad is there? It is because this hamza is causing that alif to pronounce long. Okay? Kama amana. Okay? Now, the next word, is nasun. So actually the first one is insun means a person. Insun, you know, the insan, short is insun. Insun means one person. Okay, its plural is nasun. Nasun means pupil. Nasun is the plural of insun. Nasun means pupil. Okay, if I put al before that, al means da. So the word will become the pupil. Okay? And when we put al and these two dhammas are there, they change into one dhamma here. And the word will be al naso now. Because of al, we don't pronounce two dhammas, pronounce one. Al nasu. Okay? Now in the tajweed, when there is a lam before noon, you don't pronounce noon, you pronounce annasu. Okay? So because you pronounce annasu, you put a shadda on the noon. Okay, so that's the word here. If you look in the Quran here, it's annasu. Okay? So this word will become annasu. The pupil. That's how it is written now together. You don't pronounce lam, so there is no harkat on lam. Noon should be pronounced twice, so there is a shadda on that. Annasu. The pupil. Okay? And so, the word is annasu. Annasu. And when you combine the previous word amana, then you don't pronounce this alif, you pronounce amanannasu. Because alif is not pronounced, so what happens to alif? We put little swad on it instead of this thing. That means it is now called Hamzatul Wasal, means do not pronounce it. So the pronunciation will be Amanannasu. Okay? Amanannasu, pupil believed. You don't have to say now he, because you have pupil here. So the meaning will be believe same as other pupil believed. Pupil. And here, people means other people, other than you. Okay? Other than, the person is saying to the munafiqin, other people have believed, you should believe the same way. Kama means same as. Okay? So believe as people have believed. So someone said to the Hippocrates that, my advice to you is, or my suggestion to you is that you should believe the same way other sincere people are believing. So this person said these words, and his statement ended here. Okay. So now the Hippocrates who heard that statement, they are replying. So the first